I'm involved in the vegan community, maybe like you're involved in the Bigfoot community, and that's a, what would be considered a truther community, even if it's not everyone's cup of tea.
Hello, everybody. I hope you're doing good today. This video will contain copyrighted hypocrisy being used underneath the Fair Use Act for educational purposes. Enjoy.
Wonder why one came close to where you were and was shaking a tree. Very interesting.
I don't know. I don't think that they do just live in remote areas. I think they live right alongside of us. And it's one of those things where I'm a member of a group, a Facebook group that talks about that they do research on Sasquatch, or actually they call them forest people because they are like people. They have a social structure. They have a language. And all of them say that they live, you know, right alongside of us. I'm not the only person. I've had them in my backyard. I've found footprints in my backyard. I've heard them talking in my backyard. I've just had numerous experiences right here.
Okay, I'll even concede that maybe, let's just say that maybe that all did happen. But the problem with us getting behind this as a Flat Earth community is this. It's very similar to what happened with Eric Dubé, right? And here he is, you know, one of the leading flat earthers around, and he starts promoting, you know, Hitler and saying Hitler wasn't such a bad guy. And okay, so great, maybe Hitler wasn't such a bad guy and all that, and maybe a lot of things that he said about Hitler were true. But the point is the whole subject of Hitler is a very, very charged subject. It's explosive as hell. Right. So it's really not a good thing to mix in with something that's already a very explosive subject. It's kind of like mixing nitro and glycerin. Right. What do you get? Something that's unbelievably volatile. Right. And we really, you know, honestly, we can't back or even associate ourselves with that because we're already having a hard enough time, you know, trying to get the idea of Flat Earth across seriously to people. And we certainly don't need to be hampered by the likes of, you know, little aliens, you know, talking from behind bushes.
But what does the existence of Bigfoot say about us and who we are? Is there a message in the validity of Bigfoot?
I actually feel like there's a lot that could be learned if people were more open to the idea of trying to communicate with them, because anybody can do it. Anybody, if you go into the woods or if you live somewhere where you're able to habituate with a clan or open a line of communication with them, you can do it. You just have to be open to it, and you have to go in with like love in your heart. And it sounds kind of cheesy, but if your intentions are good and you want to communicate with them, they will communicate back with you. And I think that there's a lot to be learned from them because they communicate telepathically. You know,
this is mind blowing.
Yeah. A lot of people have experienced mind speak where they've been in the woods and they hear the voice. They hear them talking to them in the woods.
This one is, I don't know if you could even call this one kind of worse, but basically what it is they're talking to a little alien that is hiding behind a tree.
And it's like, everybody to the earth, that's fine.
I know. It's like, oh my God. And of course, this is where the actual model came from. I am beside myself, guys. Don't know what to say. We got it wrong, and we will not allow these videos to stand. We've already pulled them.
He heard in his head, you know, the forest people communicated to him. They said, you know, if you want to see us, we're over here. We're just on the other side of the hill. We're here if you want to see us. And he said, he was like, you know what? I'm not ready. I couldn't deal with that right now.
Was it fear?
Probably. I mean, you know, I'll go out there and I'll like feel their presence. And I'll like, I've been out in my woods and I've felt their presence. And like, I'll feel this weird energetic vibrating feeling like through my whole body from the neck down. And I'll know like, that's gotta be them.
I just can't get behind anybody lying to people's faces like that. Like I said, if you have your own belief, if you believe in aliens and you believe in the galaxy and you believe, that's fine. You can still do experiments. And I can still take that experiments and look at them and make my own conclusions based on them. But when I see that you're telling people that you're talking to aliens in bushes, I got to draw the line.
They're extremely intelligent, and they live, you know, in complete and utter harmony on Earth, you know, with everything, with all other things in nature. They're like protectors, you know. They're a much higher minded being than the rest of us are. They vibrate higher there. And that's what I'm saying. There's a lot to learn about them. I think that's why they lie to them about us, because if people were more open to communicating with them, the things that we could learn from them, you know, along with learning that we don't live on a ball in space. I mean, if those two worlds could come together, I just feel like you could just blow the doors off so much stuff that we can't even, probably couldn't even imagine.
We really, you know, honestly, we can't back or even associate ourselves with that, because we're already having a hard enough time, you know, trying to get the idea of Flat Earth across seriously to people. And we certainly don't need to be hampered by the likes of, you know, little aliens, you know, talking from behind bushes, you know. And it's like, you know, so every research group seems to have those BLUs, all right, if you will. For example, to the mainstream cosmological model, mainstream cosmology, what is their BLU? Well, their BLU is the Electric Universe and the Thunderbolts Project, right? Anybody that is a mainstream believer cannot give any credibility to the EU model. They have to write it off as absurd, because ultimately, if they do, it completely turns their model upside down, which, of course, it's well on its way of doing. And conversely, from the Electric Universe's point of view, well, what is their BLU? Well, their BLU would be associating their model with Flat Earth.
And I think Sasquatch Bigfoot is one of those other hot potatoes and one of those subjects that if you talk about it, like Flat Earth, people think you're nuts. And that's why I'm open to all of these things.